Right, back. Just had a sugar fix, got a drink. We'll go up the lift.
Identify yourselves. Show your citizen IDs.
You know, this wasn't on the brochure. I'm not taking a cruise anymore. You know, they always never tell you the fine print stuff.
This is Queen Ming of Numara.
What? Numara?
She's a queen, you know? Off with your heads. Ring a bell, huh?
And, I wasn't notified about this. If you're the Queen of Numara, why are you coming to our country so informally? These people don't look like much of an escort.
Huh?
It's okay, it's fine.
Yeah, we're traveling incognito. Yeah, that's undercover. Hush, hush. Odd things have been happening in Numara. You know, people losing their clothes and stuff. Her Majesty felt it was her duty to come outside and do some research. You know, so be a pal. Try and help us out, you know, with this. Are you a spy, by the way?
Regulations are regulations. And there's no proof she's the Queen of Numara.
Ooh, proof. Yeah.
Proof I can furnish. Even a foot soldier such as yourself should recognize the crest of the Royal House of Numara.
Here, look at my tits.
The glowing pendant on the Queen's chest.
Hey! Hey, hey, hey! What
whoa, whoa, hey! You can't do that! You're a queen!
Yeah! I agree with you, finally. Yeah, there's gotta be a better way. Whoa, that's a very...
It can't be.
Wow. You know, you think you know someone? Nice surprise.
My sincerest apologies, Your Highness. You are without a doubt the Queen of Numara. You are most welcome to enter.
Thank you, officer. Was a daring thing to do. It was for everyone's sake.
Yeah. That was good.
And that's why I like Jansen. So, one can assume that Seth, Sarah, Kime, Gongora, they all have some sort of part as well, like that. Something to do with the magic in our bodies. Dozo. Anti-magic field.
What's this? How are we supposed to see the king?
Yeah, you know, we're not even sure if he's up there or not. I mean, looks like a maid.
Your Majesty is most kind to receive me on short notice. I am Ming, Queen of Numara. I have a most urgent favor to request.
You must have gone to considerable trouble to visit me, Queen Ming. It was my understanding, however, that your country preferred to remain isolated from its neighbors. I find it curious that you are here unannounced, with no fanfare, and accompanied by persons of uncertain character.
You have every reason to be wary, Your Majesty. It was necessary, however, for me to use such unorthodox methods. I beg your patience and ask that you hear my request.
Certainly, my dear Queen. However, I must verify that you are who you claim to be. I am aware that you demonstrated at the castle gates that you bear the glowing birthmarks of the royal house of Numara. However, in these times when magic energy is everywhere around us, it would be a simple matter to have such marks artificially added.
What are you implying, Your Majesty? You doubt her word?
Something smells fishy here, and it's not me.
Very well. In the interest of diplomacy, I shall once again demonstrate the sigil of my rank.
Your cooperation is appreciated. However, I will need a bit more proof.
Understood.
I have heard that the Queen of Numara is a capable sorcerer. If that is true, you should be able to reach me by breaching these barriers.
Yes?
Wait a minute. Let me get in front. I'll guard you.
It's all right, Jensen. Your Majesty, I will now approach the throne.
This is sus, though. I don't know if that's the king. They're implying that it is. Sus.
Well, this isn't working.
He's toying with her. Your Majesty, there is no time for such sport. We don't have much time.
Sus.
Did it break? Somebody, do something about this quick!
What is his problem?
The barriers were emanating from the throne. Even if you are the King of Gotza, how dare you behave in such a manner?
Please stay back! I had nothing to do with it! Nothing!
You're not the king. No. Not the king at all.
Yep. Sus, bro. That's the king of Argana. Of Gotza. Mickey, he ain't no mouse. He's a rat. I Oh, you dumbass. You were looking at your time. Yeah, I've got 63 grand. Boy, do I feel sheepish. Alright, you bad boy, but no more freebies. Floor 10? Don't do it! No, it was 7. Floor 7 of 9. It's Guy Incognito, a.k.a. the actual King of Goatsa.
I knew it was you.
Mars! I mean, Your Majesty.
Kaim, Sarah. It's been so many years. You're still as lovely as ever, Sarah.
Thank you. And you're still as charming as ever. Your Majesty. Why did you bring us here? Why the disguise?
This was the only way I could find to spend a few quiet moments with you. It's not widespread knowledge yet, but word is out that you've abducted the Queen of Numara. Would you mind explaining what's going on?
The Queen is with us.
Then it's true? You abducted her?
She's one of us. But it would take too long to explain.
One of you?
Yes, a fellow immortal.
So the queen who's been said to rule for 1,000 years is in fact immortal?
I consider you to be one of us too.
Even though I'm not immortal?
Not as an immortal, but as one who cares for this world.
To think that beings from another world should be the ones to teach me about love for my own world. Has it really been 50 years since we first met?
Yes. I remember.
Yes.
You have that memory?
No, my journals. You were just 20 then, weren't you?
I was certainly naive then. To go off as I did. I doubted that my inexperienced body and spirit would be equal to the demands and responsibilities of the kingship that I must one day inherit, let alone the challenges of defending my kingdom. And I wandered the world alone in search of an answer. I'd been pampered by court life, and thus I was unprepared for the demands of the journey. Perhaps I was hoping for hardship, hoping that in testing myself, I would find the strength to seek some answers.
was Kaim who found you and rescued you.
Kaim has come too. I think he'll survive.
You and Kaim were already wed by then. I was jealous. Not only were you immortal, but you also had a bride who would herself be beautiful forever. But that experience changed you. And through your journey, you found your answer.
Yes.
You'll put your life on the line to protect what you love. A truth that is as significant as it is simple. That was when you discovered it for yourself.
Oh, I remember what you told me, Kaim. Love your kingdom as you love Sarah.
Yes, you fear for the things you try to protect, and it is a fear you become accustomed to.
Thank you.
That's not the important thing.
Take this.
What matters is knowing that nothing lasts forever. Knowing that something isn't eternal makes it more precious to you. It makes it worth fighting for. Words are unnecessary. What matters is love and the will to fight for what you love.
This belongs to you.
Those words were first expressed by one of this world's ancient philosophers. His thoughts live on, even though people and history may change. The words engraved on that coin are the truth. That's why I gave it to you. I wanted you to read that, if you were ever uncertain of what to do.
Truth? Yes, these words certainly contain a truth by which one may live. Unlike you, however, I have learned through dedicating myself to the welfare of my people the impossibility of governing the world through truth alone.
You've changed.
We, the people native to this world, are different from you immortals. This truth is the most beautiful and significant to immortals such as yourselves. We mortals, however, have but a finite amount of time. Our options, like our lives, are also limited. And I have learned that sometimes one has to adopt less than ideal means to achieve ideal ends. Facts and reality sometimes demand that we take steps that contradict that very beautiful truth.
The world always holds such contradictions.
Kaim, Sarah, I have a favor to ask, now that you know my conflicted, contradictory nature. I will shortly be meeting in secret with King Tolton to discuss what can be done to avoid war, given the strained relations between our countries. He and I will consult between ourselves to avoid any interference from various vested interests on our respective sides.
You struggle to achieve your ideals, even while wrapped in contradictions.
So to speak. And I would like both of you to be present when I meet with King Tolton.
Why?
The young king and I will be struggling with the divide between truth, reality, and fact. I want your advice, given your perspective as immortals. And if we still can't find common ground and opt for war, then I ask that you not interfere.
But why male models, though?
You're suffering from having to confront an immutable reality that you cannot escape. You're every bit the man you were when we last met.
You're too kind, Sarah.
There is one thing.
Gongora.
When King Tolton arrives, tell him that his court advisor Gongora is himself an immortal, and he's using his power to try to seize control of your entire world.
What?
Remember this fact, old friend, when faced with your decision.
Queen Ming of Numara is with us. What would you say to having her attend the meeting as well? In addition, we have a favor to ask of you, too.
We need to get to Ura. For that, we need a ship capable of traversing the hypercurrents.
Very well.
We'll bring the Queen along. I'll see you at the meeting.
But why male models, though? Naruto run! Are we playing as Cook? We're Cook! Jesus Christ, she runs faster than Kaim! Heavy lightning. That sounds sus. Get back here, kid. Must be run by British Rail. There is a lot of people here. That's a lot of flavor text. Ah, I wonder if that's the king. Let's come on the train. Hey, Churl! Churl! think Jansen's got that equipped already. The escalators go to different levels. I mean, chakra arm gets him 646. Must be a family thing. I wonder if Sarah runs as fast.
To be reunited with the spirits of your loved ones. It's another world where the spirits of the dead roam. Nobody's seen one of those auroras for 30 years, though.
Bitch, what you smoking? Cats. Thank you. Wow. Okay, who the hell do I talk to? Okay. Well, obviously we sneak over using one of the other platforms or something. Yeah, okay.
Just a story. You can't see people when they're dead. Quit dreaming.
I'm not dreaming. Remember how Mom's flower saved us after Gongora wiped us out? She's here with us. Don't you want to see her too? If we can find her in the Aurora, I want to try it.
I ain't wanted to go to the fire plane yet, kid.
See Mom or not?
All right. Take your word for it. Let's do it. I'll drive this train. But I want to make this clear. Do not blame me if we screw up. This was your idea, not mine.
I know. What do you mean, you know?
Do you know what we're getting into? All right, stop crying. If we're gonna go, let's go already.
Exactly. Oh, okay, it's just a regular train. And nobody's freaking out on the platform going like, what the... The train!
Who the hell are you? It's not the main, it's the butler, I think. Where's the king?
Please, I'm sorry. Don't hurt me. Please.
You know, that's fine. You know, I've impersonated people before. I mean, you know, but yeah, just find the king for us, would you?
What a wimp. Out of my way. Want to meet my fist, your highness?
No, please.
Hey, two words. Anger management. Just relax. Don't beat the guy up. Jeez.
Thank you. You're very kind.
I hope the real king isn't as pathetic as you.
It won't do to scare the poor man speechless, Seth. I know that. Huh?
So, let's do this the easy way.
Oh, yes. Now we're talking.
Where's the real king?
Head for the train station. Our king is meeting with the king of Ura on board a train there. But no one is supposed to know.
Hey, thanks. Been a big help. Gonna make that money up somehow.
We make a pretty good team. Even if it cost us a fair amount of money.
Yeah, my money.
What?
Ming, it's like this. Seth did her pirate act to shake him up, and then I reeled him in by playing nice. You know, good guard, bad guard. It's the most basic technique for getting information out of people. I mean, we could have killed his family, but that's messy and takes too long.
Oh, so you planned it all?
Well, yeah, actually we did. It was a dirty trick. But, you know, when you're on the street, you gotta take the good with the bad.
I wasn't surprised at that. I am a queen, after all, and I've seen worse. However, what amazed me was how you two were able to work together.
What? Please don't tell me you're jealous.
Jealous? Of what? Of... Oh, no, please. Me and Pirate Girl? Come on.
What, me and Pyro go? Huh, no way. As things so happen to be... one from in here. I think I'll be calling it stream soon for me. I have a feeling yeah, we're actually gonna go in, we're gonna save, and I'm gonna call it for now. I could potentially be on somewhat later in my time. Not sure, but I will be watching a film on that tonight. Thank you all for joining. See people in the YouTube land comments if there is any, or see you possibly in the next stream. Have a good one.